Hi student, how are you? Welcome to you online classes of South Point English Boarding Schools. I am going to teach you the subject science and chapter physics of measurements. You know that measurement is necessary for different purpose. Without a measurement, we cannot get the accurate amount of the quantity. Simply, the measurement is a type of technique that is given by various purpose or various ways. Measurements in applies or that is pursued in a very ancient times or old times. In that time, the people used to farms to using the or drawing the line on the walls. So that is not an accurate amount of the measurement, and that causes the people or the businessman get loss, or that may be harm to their business. So measurement is very important to us, and measurements when we go to markets, we have to buy a various type of the object like as cloth. When we buy a cloth without a measurement, that may be in a smaller in size or bigger in size, and that is not perfect to us. So that time we need accurate amount of the measurements, and if for an accurate amount of measurement, we have need a standard quantity, and that standard quantity belongs us to the measurement. You know, simply when we buy two potatoes, the shopkeeper give us potato. In that shopkeepers is not use any standard measurement, that may be also less or more potato, and that time the cost may be 40 rupees or 60 rupees, that they may be harms or they may be loss, or we may be loss or they may be profits. So in that time we need a accurate amount of measurements. Means comparisons of two quantities. How? When we give the money and we take a potato, so the comparison between money and potato, there is the two quantity, one of the money and another is the potato. So there is the comparisons between money and potato. No, it's a wrong. It's not a comparison between money and potato. It's a comparison between standard quantities and standard quantity and the object. The object like potato and standard quantity that is to weigh. Weigh, that's like as the dhak. In Nepali, that is known as dhak. And we put a dhak of 1 kg. And we take a 1 kg of potato. That is a measurement, not a money. Measurement of the money. So measurement of money is that is the another type of the measurement. So that is also need. The measurement need us to in a various purpose or various work or to live in a simple life in our world for a scientific purpose. That is the application of the measurement for a scientific purpose. There is also measurement. Due to the lack of measurement, we cannot get a accurate result. Suppose we have to make tea. In that tea, we put the excess amount of the sugar or excess amount of the tea leaves, and that time we are not able to drink it. But because there is no proper combination of the sugar, tea and water, so that is not fit for us, and that time there also need of a measurement. Simply we eat vegetable, rice. We put the excess amount of the water in that of pots, and that time our rice is changed into the body rice. It means kitchen. So the importance of nature is very applicable in our general life, for scientific resource, for buying and selling of the objects, for medical purpose, for selling and buying of the goods, and investigations, resources, and etc. The quantity. Now we define the measurement. Measurement is the comparison of unknown standard quantity with known standard quantity is called measurement. And measurements has quantity. Like as quantity. What is quantity? Quantity is that type of amount of molecule that includes inside the object is known as quantity. You know, they may be marker, duster, book, polythene, chair, our pigs, padding, hair, our body, all other quantity or magnitudes that enclose the number of molecules, and that is quantity. Now quantity may be two types, that is physical quantity and non-physical quantity. Those quantity that can be measured, is called physical quantity, or in other words you can define as the those type of quantity that can be measured with a standard quantity directly or indirectly is called physical quantity. Physical quantity again is divided into the two types. That is, I will reach after that. So firstly know about unit. The unit, the reference standard with which we carry out the measurement of any physical quantity of the same kind is called unit. 2 meter is 2 times of 1 meters. It is units. So unit is the such type of reference standard physical quantity which carry out the measurement, and physical quantity of the same kind is called unit. Similarly, 5 kg of the potatoes and 5 kg, it means the kilogram is repeated of the 5 times repeated of the 1 kilogram. So, it's what? 1 kilogram is the unit and 5 is the physical quantity. So, the product of the physical quantity and unit is called quantity. SI unit. The SI system of unit, which is agreed by the international convenience of scientists that held in the France in 1960 AD, is called the SI unit. The system of unit, which is agreed by the international conventions of the scientists held in the France in 1960 AD, is called the SI unit. The assembly or convenience. There is the many scientists present in a France to develop a unique type of the measurement. And the by the meeting of and the result of that meeting or that convenience, that develop a special type of the standard quantity, and that quantity is known as the standard unit. And that is called SI unit, and it support from a system of unit, international system of unit D is called SI unit. The unit selecting for measuring the physical quantity must have the following characteristics. Like as those physical quantity, those have the unit should be the fixed. It means like as the fixed unit. But 1 kg potato. It means what? It means the kg, 1 kg potato root. 1 kg potato is the physical quantity and kg is the unit. It's not a meter. It's always expressed in a kg because the kg is the SI unit of mass and meter is the SI unit of length. So it's only fixed for a length and kg for mass. It's a fixed. So there should be the fixed unit. The unit should be inversely agreed. It means the dose unit that we develop that is accepted all over the world. You know, it means all quantity of the world is recognized and that is applied for fine and segment the object. Similarly, the unit should be suitable size. It means not a very large for retains or for express. The unit should be well defined and accepted all over the world. It means the definition of that unit should be a short and meaningful, not meaningless. So such type of factors as the flowing physical quantity is called the flux. Similarly, now we are going to teach about physical quantity. You know, physical quantity are two types, that is fundamental quantity and drive quantity. Fundamental quantity and drive quantity means physical quantity is two types, fundamental and drive fundamental. Fundamental quantity means those type of the physical quantity that expressed on self, not depends on others, or such quantity that expressed on self is called fundamental, and the quantity that is not expressed on self and depends for others, that is the drive quantity. So student, I am going to stop my speech. Okay, I will meet you next day. Okay, bye.